age-related hearing loss is the most significant auditory dysfunction. And I think this is going to be even more of a problem in the next 15, 20, 30 years, not just because the percentage of the elderly is increasing, but also everybody's wearing headphones and earphones and they're listening to really loud music. We're going to have a significantly more critical problem with hearing loss as people age. The main research goal of my lab is to try to understand how the brain processes sounds. So if I say thing versus saying, you know I'm saying different things because the neurons in your auditory system are responding differently. And once you understand the neurons' responses to these different sounds, then you can ask what is going wrong. We are interested in trying to understand how the brain changes with hearing loss and how we can prevent that. And that's going to have significant health impact. Close to 50% of people older than 65 will have significant age-related hearing loss. For example, language. I mean, you're not going to be able to understand what your grandchild is telling you. And that causes social isolation, that can cause depression, that can cause cognitive declines. You cannot simply just give them hearing aids and see if that enables them to hear better, mainly because the brain itself has changed. So it is important to understand what exactly the changes are in the brain before you start thinking about combining strategies such as hearing aids, behavioral therapy, and pharmacological therapy that allows us to either prevent or delay changes in hearing with age-related hearing loss. Trying to understand that language between neurons and how they communicate with each other is what really motivates me. I have this opportunity now to be in a position that allows me to inspire younger students. That's the promise I'm living right now.